Bill's Bill for Colorado 4x4 Van. Thought I'd give you guys an update. Got the truck home. Just got the last of the metal work for this year anyway done. I'll show you what we got. So we have some fenders now. They look utilitarian right now, but I'll pour 15 them just like I did the subframe. Get them black, kind of to match the front. Similar width. And there is some space there so I can put on the bigger tires if I decide to in the future. And remember, back here we're going to have some boxes eventually on the outside, be angled on both sides, and they'll probably tie into the supports for the fenders. And we've had to really think things over with the subframe and the truck frame moving like they do opposite of each other, so we've had to really think about that. He got the stairs installed for me. Had to weld on the bracket, and then they extend out, work really well. We got the back all sealed up, and this I debated on whether we should have put a whole sheet across here, just got rid of all this and resheeted the whole back, but we decided to do this. Only had to buy one sheet of aluminum this way. And we got the fenders on the other side. And these are tube steel on the outside, tube steel brackets. Everything's mounted, tied into the subframe there. And then 14 gauge steel for the fender. So I'll have to pour 15 those. Get the surface dress off there, pour 15 them, make everything match up. On the back here, we have new light boxes made. These are the LED spots that I got for the, we have two on the back here, and then there'll be one on each side, and those will be switchable from the cab, so when I need to see where I'm going, if I come in somewhere late at night, I can turn those on, look all around me. And then these lights will go in here. These are LED lights, basically replacements of my stock lights, except they have the reverse light built in also. So those are going to go there on both sides. And I'll pour 15 those too, so that they're all rust proofed. This way, if I throw up rocks from the back, it'll hit the steel and it won't break my lights, mess with anything too much. And then this entire arm, all these lights, that'll all be gone on both sides. I'll probably move my license plates up to the cab, to the camper, probably. I could put them there too, but for the future rack, I don't know what we're going to do. We were going to use the bumper as the rack. That was my idea, but then we've realize that wouldn't work because that's tied to the truck frame and that really moves when I'm driving over rough terrain. So you wouldn't want to have anything, even a spare or anything on there that's any weight, because it's going to move all the time. If we do a rack, we're going to have to attach it to the camper or the subframe, so that way it stays level with the camper all the time. So we just took that bumper off. We left the mounts. We can use that in the future if we need to. But we just took the bumper off so that we have the ground clearance for climbing up hills. I did find a mechanic in the next town over, Fort Collins, that says he can work on the truck if I find the parts. So kind of a smaller shop, work on a lot of rare cars and things like that. Friends with my wife's brother and us, for that matter. So I need to track down the parts for the truck. He'll do that, and then the local muffler shop said that they can get my muffler and exhaust pipe fixed. And that should be all that I need before we go to the Overland Expo. Inside, almost nothing has changed. But it has been warm enough. I've been leaving this window in the vent position, leaving the fan on auto. We've been in the low 70s the last couple days, which is awesome. Finally breaking into spring. One thing we did do today was get measured for the countertops. Gonna have a countertop there, here, here, and a threshold and another piece inside the shower. not going to tell you what they are. That's going to be a surprise, but they're going to be the coolest countertops ever put into a motorhome. I'm here to tell you that. Something that's very, very rare. And the best part is, it's not going to cost me anything except about 8 hours of my time, as I'm going to help my granite guy wire his basement. And in exchange for that, he's going to do my countertops in here. And he's buying all the material for that job, so it's just my time. It doesn't get any better than that, especially when you see what they are. It's going to be amazing. So I'll have that coming up. Had to cancel the Moab trip, as you may have, if you keep up, follow me on the Facebook page. Had to cancel the Moab trip because these little guys came. Very depressing. Right now I would be there if I were gone. We're still going to the Overland Expo. We already have our tickets for the weekend camping. And I hope to have this inside mostly done and livable for the three of us by then. I believe that's May 19th through the 22nd. So like third week of May. And I think I'll be able to have it done by then. If the puppy gods help me, because we are doing this ourselves and there are 9 of them. We lost one yesterday. There are 9 of them, and we're having to do a lot of extra care, so that's going to take a lot of what little extra time I had for the next 2 months. But I intend to get this as done as humanly possible. I already have all the parts. The countertops will be in about a week and a half. That'll probably be my next video. And then I can go ahead and finish up the trim work and get this interior finished up. I have all the hardware. I have all the drawer slides. I have, I think I have everything for in here. So it's just a matter of taking the time and getting it all put together. And that's coming up. So hopefully I can get all that done. And we will make our way down there. Sounds like we might have some caravanners coming with us from the Denver area that are going also, and they'd like to drive along with us. So it's going to be a good time. Looking forward to it. At any rate, a lot of work between now and then, but I'll put up another video probably when the countertops are in, because I'm telling you, you're going to love this. It's going to be awesome. Until next time.
Gripping the wheel, his knuckles went white with desire. The wheels of his Mustang exploding on the highway like a slug from a 45. True death. 400 horsepower of maximum performance, piercing the night. This is Black Sun.